Hi, this is Surekha. I'm going to talk about four stages of human development. This is otherwise called as four planes of development. This is given by Maria Montessori. She has observed children over the age of 0 to 24 and she has given this picture. 0 to 6, she called it as infant, 6 to 12 childhood, 12 to 18 adolescent, 18 to 24 maturity, and the development happens till death. According to her, life starts at conception. 0 to 3 and 3 to 6 is the subdivision within 0 to 6. In 0 to 3, she called it as period of acquisition, whereas 3 to 6, she called it as period of rectification. Whatever they observe and absorb in the age of 0 to 3, they reflect in the age of 3 to 6. She has also said that there is a similarity in the behavior pattern of 0 to 6 and 12 to 18. Now, let's look at 0 to 6 in detail. Before that, let's talk about their focus and their craving. In the age of 0 to 6, these children, their focus is only on themselves. They feel they are the center of this universe. And whereas 6 to 12, their focus is much on family and friends, the next circle. Here, they crave for physical independence. They want to move. They want to move their hands and legs, and they crave for that. Here, they crave for intellectual independence. And about this age, like 12 to 18 and 18 to 24, their focus is much on society and the global community. They want to work for a cause. They like to work in groups, and they earn for economic independence and financial independence. Now, let's look about 0 to 6 in detail. Yes, now let us look at 0 to 6, the behavior pattern, their developmental needs in detail. In four aspects: physical, cognitive, emotional and social. What they need physically, what they need for their mental growth, what they need emotionally, and how they can gel themselves in a society. First, let's talk about their physical needs. Their hands have to be used as much as possible. It has to be sensitized. They work through their senses, and if you would have seen children repeating the same thing many times, few babies, few children, they want a story to be read again and again. Few children, if we would have observed them closing and opening the door again and again, because it is their inner urge, that is their developmental need within them. It is not that they just want, someone is coming and they want to open the door. It's just that they want to repeat. By that, they are striving for perfection. They will gain much more control. It is their inner urge to repeat that, and that is the way for perfection. This way, they easily understand what is perfection, and that is the way they gain control. And next is develop coordination. This is the critical phase where they develop a coordination. Suppose they want to learn dance or music. So it should be appealing for their senses through intelligence. And for this activity, they need their eye-hand coordination, their legs coordination, which we call it as motor skills. And they have to feel that, yes, I want to learn. That feeling, that inner urge, that driving force. So all these three powers should coordinate. This is the phase where we lay a foundation for that. And this is the critical phase. This is the phase where we lay the foundation for achieving any mastery. Nutrition. When I talk about nutrition, they need physical nutrition as well as psychical nutrition. Physical nutrition, yes, a very balanced diet. Not only that, psychical nutrition. Don't feel that just the baby is fed and weekend, the baby is ready to sleep. You have to engage these babies. Talk to them, sing to them, they can, even though you may feel that they are not understanding. They will observe the lip movements. And have you ever wondered how we learned our mother tongue? Is anybody teaching it? We just absorb the environment. They are like sponge. Whatever is rich in the environment, they absorb it like a sponge. If music is very much alive in the environment, they'll pick it up. If slogans or songs is what, if the language is very much alive in the environment, they will pick it up very easily. There is a high rate of growth, so they need very frequent meals or nutrition. hygiene. This has to be taught to them, like any hygiene related to face or any with the hands. It has to be taught in this age. If they fall sick, they will bounce back from illness quickly. Life skills. We have to involve them in any domestic chores, for example, in cooking, whatever is possible for their little hands, that we can ask them to do. For example, shelling or folding or like carrying something. So this is the way they will gain much more control. This is the phase where they will start writing at the age of 4. That is the right age for writing. For that, they need a good pencil grip. So by using their hands as much as possible, they gain this control. Their fine motor skills will get enhanced. Their eye-hand coordination will get developed. Next, we'll quickly move on to IQ. What they need for their mental growth. These children in the age of 0 to 6, they learn through their senses. So intellect can be reached indirectly. They, by their visual sense, by their auditory sense, by their muscular sense, whatever they do, they will observe and learn. Whatever they listen, by that they will learn. So they learn through their senses. They enjoy slapstick comedy. You would have seen babies, just they laugh continuously, seeing anything is funny, anything is exaggerated, they love to watch that. And to learn any concept like shapes or colors, they need concrete materials. So that is how they, using their senses, they manipulate that material, and that is how they learn. We can involve them in few activities like matching, pairing, sorting, and that is how they learn. They feel they are the center of universe, as I told you earlier. And these children in the age of 0 to 6, we call them, they fall in the what plane. They are recurrently, very, you would have seen children asking questions like, what is that? What is this? So this is the plane where they want to know what is that. They don't want to know why it is happening. They just want to know what is this, right? Next, home and school separation. Many parents ask, why my child is not opening up? Why my child is not talking about what's happening in the school environment? They live for that moment. They live in the present. They can't connect these two environments. They are just happy in the environment where they are. And that is why we call it as home and school separation. And the sense of order is very high. If they see any particular thing is missing in one place, they keenly observe, because this is the phase where their senses work very optimally, unlike others, right? Let it be seeing or hearing. So what are these? Touching, smelling, anything, even sniffing, their senses work very optimally. If something is like it's given a different place, if you keep it in somewhere, we have to inform them, and that is why I call it as sense of order is high. When you are talking about stories, when you are reading stories, please choose books which are real time stories, because they can't connect with imagination or any fantasy story. 6 to 12 is the age where they can connect with imagination or abstraction. So whatever you are doing or whatever the stories you are telling, it should be based on real time characters, like not like animals are talking, nothing like that. No fantasy stories. Next, talk about emotions. So children in this age group of 0 to 6, they express their emotions spontaneously. It can be any emotion. It can be happiness or sorrow, whatever. They express it very spontaneously, and they build trust or mistrust in oneself or in an environment. This is the time where they develop that interest, right? And they are very autonomous, like they are very individualistic. Next point is, they do not need any acclaim. They do not want any appreciation. Only adults, it is us who introduce something called appreciation. They need only encouragement. If you want them to involve in some activity, just motivate them, encourage them. You need not even clap hands. It is adults, like how we introduce pizza to a child, that is how we are introducing appreciation to them, like clapping hands or telling good, smart, nothing. But they do not have an inner urge for appreciation. It is like adults, us, we introduce appreciation to them. They need only encouragement. They recognize and accept differences. If you say something, they will accept it happily. They without any value judgments, and they can recognize physical differences like gender. They can differentiate like a male from female. Next is towards the end of the phase, they can distinguish what is real and what is real. If we do any role play, they think it's very real. And as I told you already, they express any feelings very spontaneously. Let's quickly move on to the social aspect. This is the phase where they play parallelly or they work alone. Because they do not have that inner urge to play with other children, right? They are very happy in their own way. Okay, so they play parallelly. You would have seen children, even though you take them for a play date, initial days, they do not show any interest to work or play with other children, and they are very individualistic. And at the next level, they can think about only their friends or the family. Their family is their base. And 2.5 to 3 years is the right age for them to move them outside, to think about the next community or the school. Now, next, we have to introduce them in group or collective experiences. So this is the time where parents, they have to involve their children in play dates. And that is how they develop interest for social skills or social gatherings. They are very careful. They do not like to take any risk. They just do what they do. Next. They empathize with younger children and animals. Yes, if we give them a responsibility to take care of younger children, they feel very responsible and they take care of them very nicely. And love for silence. They exhibit a love for silence, and this is the age. And much relatively, this is the phase where you can see them much calmer, relatively. Right, so we have seen about the developmental needs, their behavior patterns, what they need from their family, all in a nutshell today. I hope you enjoy watching it. I hope this will be useful to you. Thank you.